Are you okay? You do realize that you are alone at night in the Gryffindor common room. You're not sleepwalking, are you? Oh, yeah, I do realize I am also. No. I haven't been to Honeydukes. No, I've just been patrolling the school grounds. I don't know if you've met me or noticed, but I'm a prefect of the school, so I've been making sure that we haven't got any students up and wandering the grounds at night, just to make sure that everyone is safe and sound and fast asleep. It's a duty that I've been charged with, and I 100% haven't been down to Hogsmeade, especially Honeydukes, either. These are things which I picked up from the Great Hall. Yep. These were actually my feast. Are you sure you're okay? It's very late, and there was barely any light on in here. Yeah. What year are you in again? Ah, that's why. I expect Hogwarts feels a little bit overwhelming on your first nights here. Ah, yes. I remember my first nights too. Don't worry, it can sometimes feel a little bit overwhelming, but you're magical, are you not? You're here to learn magic. That means that even when it comes to getting to sleep, you could use magic to help you fall asleep. Well, obviously, just joining Hogwarts here, you probably haven't been taught all these things yet, but I, like you, used to be like that. You couldn't sleep at night, and maybe sitting here in the common room is probably not the best things to do to help you sleep. So maybe it was a good job which I had, that I bumped into you tonight, because I think I can teach you a couple of spells, a couple of tricks to help you fall asleep, or just relax and get you in the mood for more sleep. What classes have you got tomorrow? I think he's a new professor, Professor Quirrell. Yep, I haven't seen him here at the school before. And of course we have a celebrity in the school now, I'm sure you've heard. It might be in your class. Of course, Harry Potter. Yes, you guessed it. In this Gryffindor common room. It's pretty amazing, isn't it? Yeah, but sounds like you've probably got a busy day in Defense Against the Dark Arts with Professor Quirrell. So I think that it's probably best that I pop some of these down and I can help you with a couple of spells to get you back either to sleep or relax here in the common room. Alright. What was your name again? Pleased to meet you. My name's Fred. So how about the fireplace? Watch this. Incendio. That's a lot better, isn't it? Well, you can't not relax and not have a fireplace. Just put all my stuff on the sofa there. Right. So, how long have you been sitting there? You haven't been walking around the school grounds, have you? That's great. No, of course, don't walk around the school late at night. A lot of the teachers and professors will tell you not to do so as well. There are more strange, magical things which fill these castle walls. Things which I'm sure that maybe for a new wizard such as yourself and witches, that you might find it a little bit overwhelming. So don't do that. Good. Good. No, that's good. So, obviously, being a prefect of that, I make sure that none of the students are running around or walking around or exploring late at night, because I know in an exciting new place such as Hogwarts that you would have a tendency to go and explore and open your eyes to this great big new world that you have just been placed in. But I assure you, if you stay in the common room at night, get the great best night's sleep possible, you will have a great time exploring daytime tomorrow. So there's no need to go out late at night. Plus, you don't want to go anywhere near the Forbidden Forest. That's probably somewhere that you don't want to go. So, you don't mind if I eat, do you? That's that good. Lumos. Okay, let's see what we've got here. Fizzing Wisbies. Have you ever had these? Have you been to Honey Dukes in... I mean, I haven't been to Honeydukes. No, I didn't go to Hogsmeade. No, of course I was being a prefect and patrolling the school. Nox. These look quite nice. Would you like some? That's a good answer. It's probably best not to eat just before you go to bed. Things which you will learn when you want to fall asleep here at Hogwarts, that magic can have a great influence over how you feel. How are you with magic? Have you done much at home? A little bit. Well, of course, just know that when you finish Hogwarts, that you will know pretty much everything. And you can learn about even more things. Sleep is one of the things which I wanted to specialize in. And being a wizard who likes to go and explore places, then I think it's important that when I go to sleep, that you fall asleep. A bit like what might happen to you now. See the top of my wand here? Just kind of flourish it. Either side of you. You don't need to move. These are just little things which worked for me to help me start to get a little bit relaxed. So why don't we do that? Don't worry, I will help you on your first nights get back to sleep, and you'll be feeling good for classes tomorrow. Okay. Sounds pretty nice, doesn't it? Would you like it on the other side as well? These are just little flourishes which I learned myself. And I haven't really told anyone about it. This is what I've used on myself. And this has always helped me, so I really hope this is going to help you too. Sad for you. These are just relaxing techniques, being witches and wizards, we can manipulate things to make us feel certain ways and make us feel good and sleepy and almost a tingly feelings that you get. These are powerful tools for making you feel sleepy and relax, and of course go into Defense Against the Dark Arts classes tomorrow. I don't know what that Professor Quirrell was like. I heard he's a bit jumpy. I haven't met him yet. But when you go to class, I'm sure you'll have a great time going, but you'll want to make sure that you've had a great night's sleep. So there's certain techniques that you can try. Maybe you'd like to try yourself. Maybe you'd like to cast a certain spell. So you see on the fireplace here, perhaps you'd like to make the fireplace turn a different color. Perhaps green. Okay. Can I see your wand a second? Yeah, no, that's... I'll just have a quick look. This is a nice wand. Slightly flexible. Unicorn hair. I shouldn't know these things, but I do for some reason. And made of elm. This is a powerful wand. However, your emerald jewel here somewhat concerns me. Especially in this house. The sword in that sorts you in a house which it thinks is best for you. Some say Gryffindor are filled with courageous individuals, students who have courage and loving nature and giving kind. So being here, you must have all those attributes there as well. All the things which Godric Gryffindor would have wanted the students in Gryffindor to possess. So maybe we'll just see what we can do with this wand. Okay, let's see if we can make the same sort of sparks again. I'll show you that you can do it on your wand. Okay. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh no. That's an umbrella there for me. It appears that you've made it rain here, or your wand has at least. Let me give that back to you there. That's great. And perhaps if you'd like to wave your wand a little bit, it's just raining on you. A little bit there, not so much for me. Yeah, just wave your wand a little bit. There. That's great. So, you might need just a little bit of training in that. But don't worry, I can teach you all of that. One of the things in the common room, when it's this late, everyone's asleep. So, you can always come down, relax, and this is what I did. And in fact, the prefect taught me the very same thing which I am teaching you tonight. And these are the things which always stay with you. They always do. And then you teach them on to younger students, etc., etc. I'm sure you'll become a prefect as well. I'm sure Professor Dumbledore will see what talent you possess. Really good. Honeydukes is such a... I didn't go there. It was at the Great Hall. At the Great Hall. So maybe you'd like to try one more. If you focus and pay your attention on the wand, when you make a flourish, you will feel a slight little bit of resistance in your wand. Then think about that's some soothing spell which I made. Okay, a bit like this. Okay. That's it. And think of the spell. You don't need to say any words, just think about the spell. No, it's snowing now. Okay, let's stop thinking about the spell. That's great. I'm just gonna make the fireplace a little bit warmer there. Incendiary. It's always very relaxing to have a nice fire going. And there's nothing quite nicer than being in the common room late at night when all the other students and all my friends have gone to bed. I get to actually relax here. And it's important to have that quiet time, which I'm sure you'll find out, because Hogwarts is an amazing, exciting place to be, but it's also very tiring, and your energy, because you'll be doing so much, you might be playing some Quidditch, you might be going for other lessons with different professors, or professors might task you to do certain things. You get to help Hagrid, who is the groundskeeper here. The half giant, you can't miss him. So you might be doing all sorts of jobs and finding your path at Hogwarts. Okay. One thing, I don't know if you saw many of them yet, but yeah, there are some ghosts which say visit Gryffindor common room. Nearly headless neck. Did you meet him at the Great Hall in the feast? Yeah, he's great. And nearly headless neck. Yeah, he's notoriously a fan of all Gryffindors, and rightly so, because we of course are the best. But I don't know if you've met Hendrik Hinderwell as well. He's a great ghost, but he usually comes out late at night. He's a great ghost. Yeah, he usually sticks around in Gryffindor common room, and he usually sits down by the fireplace and reads something, and you might get to talk to him, but he's always very tired and very sleepy. But it's quite rare that you see Hendrik Hinderwell, but he's one of my favourite ghosts. Maybe if we create a relaxing environment, enough environment, then we might get to see him tonight. But we'll see how we get on. Okay. So I think now that we've sort of got you in a bit more of a relaxed state of mind, I think we should try a couple more charms, which I think, and spells, which I think is really going to help you. And if you want to switch off, then you can. And don't worry, I'll take all of my sweets back to my dorm. And you can relax here. I'll dole down the fireplace there for you if you do, in fact, drift off. And it's quite fine to fall asleep on the surface here at Gryffindor Common Room. It's a very relaxing place for you to be. But one thing I will ask you first is the reason that you are not sleeping. It's not because of any thoughts which you're thinking about. I hope it's because you're excited and really enjoying Hogwarts, but sometimes memories are things which keep us up at night, things that keep us awake and stop us from sleeping and having a good night's sleep and being magical witches and wizards, of course, which I'm not sure if you know, but you can take out your memories and you can preserve them in a vial or any bottle or anything like that. So any troubling thoughts, you can take it out and you can place it in a vial and you won't have to worry about it. You'll remember that there's a memory there, you just wouldn't know what that memory is until you see that memory again. This is really quite advanced magic, and you'll learn it at Hogwarts, but how about if I just show you? Well, I don't know if you've met the potions professor, Professor Snape, head of Slytherin. He can be quite intimidating. I think we're all quite scared of him, really. But you will learn some really great spells with him and potions. And one of the things which we learned from him was extracting memories. So let me show you. See, I think of a memory. And then I pull out that memory. I take my vial. So it's always going to be there, but it's something which I don't have to worry about. So if you've got any troubling thoughts, then I can of course extract them for you and place it in a vial. There is one thing. Well, that thing, we can take it out if you want. It's probably best that you don't tell too many people about this. This is really advanced magic, but if you place it in a vial, keep it safe. You'll always have that memory there, whatever's on your mind. I've got another vial here, you can have this one. But if you think of that memory, that thing which is keeping you up, keeping you from falling asleep and just feeling good, anything troubling that's on your mind, or something you just don't want to be there and thinking about, think about it now. Think about it and how it makes you feel. Just relive that thought, that memory that you've got there. Keep thinking about it. Keep thinking about it. Keep thinking about it. Keep thinking about that memory. Keep thinking about that memory. Keep thinking about that memory. You see it? That is the memory which we've taken out. Do you remember that memory that was keeping you awake there? There is a thought which now is in here, which you don't have to think about anymore. And if there's any others, then we can give you another one. There you go, take that. And keep it safe, of course. But if there's any other thoughts, we can extract that for you as well. Just to help you sleep better. And it's so easy to remember these thoughts. You just take out the vial and it will find its way back to you because it's your memory. So how about that we try just that other thing that you're thinking about. And I have one more vial here that we can store that memory for you, so you don't have to worry about that at all. Of course you don't have to get rid of it, but I assure you it really helps when you sleep. I've got so many vials tucked under my bed in my dorm, and those are usually memories I just don't really want to think about, so it really does help just to take out the thoughts, and then falling asleep after it will be so easy. Okay, let's see if we can do it. Okay, so try and focus on that thought. Focus on that thought. Focus on that thought. Focus on that thought. Focus on that memory. Keep thinking about 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 that memory. Thinking about that memory. Keep thinking about that memory. And this. You are the memory. Do you remember what that thought was? Good. But like I said, you can just remember it by literally opening it up and it will find its way back to you whenever you want to think about that thing that you don't remember thinking about. That's perfect. Here he comes. Here's Hendrik Kinderwell. Hello there, Hendrik.
It's going to be one of those nights, I see.
It's late at night.
No.
You don't need to go.
Excuse me, Fred. I want to sleep now.
I hate it when they do that. I think he's probably found it a relaxing environment here tonight. Hendrik. Nope. Hendrik's quite happy over there now. Well, that's a good sign. Ghosts aren't scary here in the Gryffindor common room. It's really nice because if you see Hendrik, then that means one, you're lucky. Which wizard, and two, that it means it's a very sleepy environment. So, Hendrik, only goes to the sleepiest of places. Maybe he'll come over later on. I don't know. So, I think that you, I think you can do with a couple of other spells. Well, how about that we just change that fireplace? It seems to be dulling out a little bit there. So let's incendio. Is that a bit better? That's good. And how about a couple more flourishes there for you as well? Okay. Shouldn't worry, you'll be able to do it to yourself in no time. For me, literally, if I can't fall asleep, if I've had a busy day in class or the professor, sometimes magic really does make you think and sleepy and tired and everything else which is going on. You just need a couple of wand flourishes or quick spells to make you feel good. For example, I would go back to my dorm and I would just relax, listen to the sound, it's very satisfying. And again, it's really, really satisfying. And it's great to look at as well. Though I do find the glow of a LUMOS light will be very, very beneficial for you for the sleep. So maybe just a little Lumos Nox Lumos. It is great to see you.
Stop that. Stop. No. Turn that thing off.
Hendrik, this is our new student here, and they're new to the Gryffindor common room.
Nice to make your acquaintance. New student. Can I interest you? History of magic. I'll take it if you're going to need anything. Oh. I'm sorry. Yes, special ghost edition, I'm afraid. Not for you.
So much, but he does enjoy flipping through pages on his books and scrolls and everything which he likes to read. Isn't that right, Hendrik? Are you going to find you a comfortable space? Maybe a servant? He keeps doing that. Just goes straight through you. Oh, such a strange feeling. But Hendrik, if you get him to talk, that means that he's going to be very fond of you. So the fact that he came over was just him sussing you out to begin with, but he's one of the wisest ghosts here at the castle. He's very well read and is always helpful when you want to learn new spells and things. Well, I noticed that you are getting a little bit more tired, but you're not quite ready for sleep yet. But you're close. Well, there is a spell which I was thinking of. A certain spell which its purposes aren't really for sleeping, but more to steer away dementors, I'm sure. Yeah, you've heard of them. Yeah, no one really wants to think about them, and that's a memory that if you have one of them, you probably want to lock away in a vial and take them all out. But the charm to repel them. Have you heard of it? Yeah. So, you know the spell, but it's a very complicated spell. A Patronus charm. Only skilled witches and wizards are able to perform this. I've been taught it recently, though I'm not quite at the stage where an animal appears from your wand. That's a very powerful Patronus, but I know the very basics of that Patronus. I was taught it last year, and I went for after school practices as well with the professor, but he's not there anymore. Now it's Professor Quirrell. But I did learn the Patronus charm, and there's something magical, there's something so relaxing and nice about the spell, which is really, really sleep inducing. I think if we use that spell, then it's probably going to help you quite a lot tonight. Though, this is something which, strictly speaking, I'm probably not supposed to cast, but I think that it's going to really help you. And if this is a thing that makes you fall asleep, then that's just between you and the school prefect, being prefect, and then of course I'm pretty much allowed to cast whatever spells which I want here. So some rules I can bend just a little bit, all for the greater good. And that's you finding some rest and sleeping easy tonight here at Hogwarts. Okay. So, the thing with the Patronus charm, you might feel some sounds or feel some feelings and hear some sounds and see something very enticing, entrancing, and it's really nice. I think you're going to like it. Okay. So, how about we dim the lights down here a little bit? And the lamps. Maybe the fireplace a little bit too. Is it a little bit better? Okay. So, Expecto Patronum. Isn't it? This is a spell which creates good and is made from happy memories, and those are the things you need to help you sleep, and that feeling and that sound that it makes you want to sleep every single time. I will cast as many as I need to help you fall asleep. Expecto Patronum. Expecto Patronum. Because I'm not that skilled of a wizard, that my Patronus charms don't last as long as I'd like them to, but it's a work in progress. But it's a very relaxing spell, one that gives you great feelings, and when you cast it as well, I feel those things which is my Patronus, and I know it's not going to be long until my animal is shown as well. But I think that it will be long, and I know that this is going to be the cure for me when I want to fall asleep instantly. And you will learn the same thing. It begins with the wand flourishes, creating a nice ambiance with the fireplace, or maybe a sort of weather. I mean, you did it with the snow and the rain and things like that. You've also got things you can get from honey jokes to make you feel good. But anything down the Hogsmeade, there's always things to make you feel happy and relaxed here at Hogwarts, and hopefully that your days and all your classes and all your friends and all the professors are going to love you, and you will love being here and enjoy your time at Hogwarts. Well, it's been a pleasure to meet you, and I'm sorry that you were, well, hopefully you weren't sitting up here by yourself for too long. Well, I'm glad that I came back when I did. I mean, strictly speaking, I was due one more lap around the castle, but I was somewhat interested in my collection tonight of treats. And yes, it was from Honey Jukes, but you don't need to tell anyone about that. Okay. Well, I will teach you those charms if you want, so the flourish. Just those small things you can do with your wand to help you sleep, and also the basic charms of Lumos, Nox, Lumos, Nox, and perhaps if your wand wasn't so tired, then it wouldn't cast random spells for you. There. I think that was just because the rain and the snow was just how he was feeling, and you just wanted a little bit of sleep. That's what that told me. I picked up on that quite early on, but now I think if you were doing that flourish, you should be able to do it as well. But you don't need to try. You can relax here as much as you want. Enjoy the fireplace, enjoy the common room. I will make a couple more Patronuses. Then I will go back to my dorm. But if there's anything you need during your time here at the school, my name is Fred, and it was really great to meet you, and I hope you're going to enjoy your time here at Hogwarts. Hendrick, I think Hendrick's wanting to say goodbye. Hendrick, are you going to... No, I don't think you're saying goodbye, but yeah, thank you, Hendrick. I think he's a great ghost, really. Him and Nearly Headless Nick, I think, are my favourite ghosts here at Hogwarts, but you will meet many amazing things, people, and see amazing things here at the castle. So lots of exciting things to explore and do. But first, you try and sleep. And I hope I've been a good prefect and helped you out, a student indeed. Good. And I'm sure that you'll have a great time there. Expecto Patronum. Expecto. Send you.